Did You Know video series from the National Cancer Institute, Hepatitis and Liver Cancer. Did you know that chronic hepatitis B and C virus infections can cause liver cancer? The good news is that there's a vaccine to prevent hepatitis B virus infection, and there are effective treatment options for hepatitis C virus infection. Chronic infection with hepatitis B and C viruses can cause inflammation or swelling of the liver. Long-term damage to the liver from these viruses can increase the risk of liver cancer. Hepatitis B and C viruses can be passed from person to person through blood, other bodily fluids, or sexual contact. A newborn may get infected with hepatitis B virus from its mother if she's infected. Although hepatitis B and C virus infections are contagious diseases, liver cancer is not. The hepatitis B vaccine can reduce your risk of liver cancer. The U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, or CDC, recommends infants receive the vaccine, as should at-risk adults who have not had hepatitis B virus infection or the hepatitis B vaccine. There is no vaccine currently available for hepatitis C virus. Americans born between 1945 and 1965 are 5 times more likely to have hepatitis C virus infection than are other adults. That's why the CDC recommends that anyone born during this time get tested for the virus. In 2013, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration approved the use of 2 new antiviral drugs to treat chronic hepatitis C infection, and there are now several treatment options available. Early diagnosis and treatment of hepatitis C virus infection can reduce your risk of liver cancer. New diagnoses of liver cancer are highest among American Indians and Alaska Natives, followed by Asians and Pacific Islanders, and Hispanics. In all racial and ethnic groups, new diagnoses of liver cancer are twice as high in men as they are in women. Rates of new liver cancer diagnoses for all races and ethnicities increase with age, with some variation among racial and ethnic groups. For example, in recent years, new diagnoses rates among blacks showed a peak at ages 60 to 64 and then decreased among persons older than 64. In contrast, diagnosis rates among American Indians and Alaska Natives showed a peak among persons aged 55 to 59, followed by a slight decline among persons aged 60 to 64, and then an increase until ages 80 to 84. In addition to chronic viral hepatitis infections, other important risk factors for liver cancer include heavy alcohol use, diabetes, obesity, and metabolic syndrome. Talk with your doctor about treatment options for hepatitis B and C virus infections and other ways to reduce your risk for cancer. Each year, the National Cancer Institute, American Cancer Society, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, and the North American Association of Central Cancer Registries collaborate to provide updated information on cancer in the United States. This year's annual report to the nation highlights the increasing burden of liver cancer and emphasizes efforts to prevent, identify, and treat chronic hepatitis B and C viral infections and other key risk factors for liver cancer. For more information on hepatitis B vaccine and treatment options for viral hepatitis B and C infection, visit cdc.gov/hepatitis. For more information on liver cancer, visit cancer.gov or call 1-800-4-CANCER. For more information on the annual report to the nation and more cancer statistics, go to seer.cancer.gov.